Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernardo from the BTN HD, and today is all about installing MDT 8456. Now, this is the step-by-step process, so let's get started. Now, the first thing that we need to do is download the MDT 846 executable file. I will provide the link for you guys, so don't worry about it. This is the website. You're going to click on download, and once you click on download, it's going to give you an option to download the 64-bit or the 86-bit. Now, for me, I'm downloading the 64-bit, so that's what I chose. And I clicked on next, and it's going to start downloading. It's pretty quick, all right? So don't worry about it. Now, the next thing that we need to do is install the Windows 10 ADK. Now, I will provide the link for you guys to go directly to this website, but there's two links and two installation files that you need to download. One is the Windows ADK for Windows 10 version 1809, and for some reason, Microsoft kind of split up the Windows PE, so we need to download that as well. So what you're going to do is click on download Windows ADK for Windows 10. And once that's done, it's pretty fast. And the next one is download the Windows PE add-on for your ADK. Okay, so it's three files that you need. Now I'm doing everything within a Windows Server 2019. Why not? Because Server 2019 is going to be the latest operating system. So let's get started with that. Now, first things first, I have a folder on my desktop called V8456. Inside that folder, I have all my exe files. I have my ADK for my WinPE, and also my Microsoft Deployment Toolkit, which is 8456, okay? Now, the first thing I'm going to run is my ADK, okay? I'm going to right-click on it and run it as an admin. It's going to start loading up, and you're going to get this. I left it as the default setting as install the Windows Assessment and Deployment Kit on this computer. Click on next. I hit no on this, next again, accept the license and terms. I left everything as the default and click on install, and eventually it's going to go through, grab all the files that it needs, and it's going to download and install on your machine. And once it's done, you're going to get this. Awesome, right? Click on close. Next thing that we need to do is the ADK Windows PE. So right click on that and run it as an admin. Again, it's going to start loading up. You're going to get this. By default, it's going to have install the Windows Assessment Deployment Kit for Windows Pre-Installation Environment add-on. Leave it as is. Click on next. I hit no on this. Click on next. Accept the license and terms. And there's only one option, so just leave it. It's the default one that's selected. So click on install. This process takes a while because there's a lot of files that are being grabbed from the internet world and dropped inside your server and going to be installed. Once everything is completed, you're going to see this, and that's half the battle. So I went inside my control panel, and the reason why I went inside my control panel, because I want to show you guys that everything is installed. The version that I'm using is 17.7.6.3, which is for the support for Windows 10 version 1809. Now it is time for us to install MDT 8456. Now this is a fresh installation. This is basically a step-by-step installation guide for you guys. So we're going to right-click on our Microsoft Deployment Toolkit and click on install. It's going to start loading up, and you're going to get this. So you're going to click on next, accept the license and terms, click on next again. I left everything as the default inside the C drive. Click on next. I don't want to participate on this program, so I said I don't want to join the program at this time. Click on next, install, and you're done. It's really easy, okay? We're going to click on finish. Once you click on finish, click on start and locate the deployment workbench and click on it. It's going to start loading up. And eventually, once it loads up, the next thing that we need to do is locate your deployment share node, right-click on it, and click on new deployment share. It's going to start loading up the wizard and give it a path. Now, by default, it goes to the C drive. I like to drop it inside a secondary partition, and it's normally my D drive, so that's why I changed it. Click on next. The share name, I always leave it as the default, but it's up to you. You are able to change it, and I clicked on next here. The descriptive name, I leave it as a default. I leave a lot of stuff as default, especially when it's in the lab environment, but you are able to customize all this stuff within your lab. Click on next. The options, again, I leave it as the default, but you are able to customize it for your environment. Click on next again. A nice little summary, next, and it's going to do its thing. And once it's finished, you're done. Click finish. And now you have your MDT deployment share, which if you click on the little arrow, you get your application, operating system, out-of-the-box drivers, packages, task sequence, advanced configuration, and monitoring. Okay, we're almost done. Now, next thing that we need to do is import an operating system. Now, if you have been checking out all my MDT videos, I love creating folders. That's my thing. So within the operating system, node, I right-clicked on it, and you guessed it, I'm going to create a new folder. And the folder is going to be called Windows 10 x64 Enterprise V1809. Click on next, next, and finish. Done, right? How easy is that? Basic steps on creating a folder. Now it's time for us to import the operating system in. Now, because I'm doing this within a virtual environment, I already mounted my ISO, my Windows 10 1809 ISO within my virtual machine. So I'm going to right click on the folder and import an operating system. You're going to get the import operating system wizard. By default, you have full set of sources files selected. So I'm going to leave that as is and click on next. Now the source directory, I'm going to click on browse and I'm going to browse. For me, it was this PC. And I located the E drive, which the E drive is my DVD or my ISO, which is mounted on my virtual machine. And I'm just going to select the entire E drive. Click OK. Click on next. Destination directory name, I'm going to leave it as the default because that's what the wizard provided. Click on next. Nice little summary. Next again. It's going to do its thing. Now, this process takes a while because it's grabbing all that content within the ISO and dropping it locally within your deployment share. Once everything's completed, you're going to get this. Awesome. Click finish. And my ISO had a lot of different flavors of Windows 10. Okay. Next thing that we need to do is create a task sequence. Again, I love creating folders. So within your task sequence node, I right clicked on it, new folder. And the folder name that I provided was Windows 10 TS. Now, for TS for me stands for task sequence. But you are able to call it whatever you want. Again, you don't need to create folders, but this is the way I like to do things. Click on next here. Nice little summary. Click next. It's going to start doing this thing and it's done. Creating folders are super easy within MDT. Okay. Now from here, click on finish. And it's time for us to create a new task sequence. So within my new folder, I right clicked on it. New task sequence. It's going to open up the wizard and you're going to provide the following. A task sequence ID and a name. So I give it Win10V1809, makes kind of sense. And the name was Windows 10 X64 Enterprise V1809 Deploy TS. TS stands for task sequence. Click on next. This is going to be a standard client task sequence. It's just going to deploy the operating system and that's it. But you are able to choose other templates. For me, I just left it as is, clicked on next, and then pick your operating system. So click on the folder, expand it. And for me, I picked the Windows 10 Enterprise. Click on next. I'm not going to specify a product key right now. Click on next. Provide a full name, organization, and also a home page for your Internet Explorer. I gave it all this information. Click on next. Also provide an admin. Now, this admin password is for the local admin account within your Windows 10. Okay. This is not an Active Directory admin account, only local. So add it, confirm it, click on next. Nice little summary. Click on next, and it's done. Awesome. How easy, right? Now, before I even go inside MDT and update the deployment share, because that's the next step, I need to add a new feature within the server, and that's WDS, Windows Deployment Services, because that's the way I like to deploy my operating systems. I like to Pixie. So I'm going to click on Start, and I'm going to choose Server Manager. I'm going to let that load up. Click on Manage, Add Roles and Features. You're going to get the Add in Roles Features Wizard. Click on Next. Next again, next again. And within this section right here with server roles, you're gonna locate Windows Deployment Services. You're gonna check it off. You're gonna definitely add all the features that you need and click on next, next again, next again. You're gonna leave the default deployment server and the transport server. You need those two, don't worry about it. Then click on next, click on install and done. How easy is that? Click on close. Now, you install WDS, which is pretty easy, but we need to configure it. So click on Start, and within Start, you're going to go inside Windows Administrative Tool folder, go all the way to the bottom inside that folder, and locate Windows Deployment Services. So once you click on it, it's going to start loading up. Next thing that we need to do is open up or expand your servers node, and you're going to see your fully qualified domain name of the computer that you're installing, you know, WDS and MDT. For me, it was VMDT. 8456 dot my domain, and you're going to get a nice little exclamation point because it needs to be configured, right? So all you're going to do is right click on it and configure the server. You got a nice little wizard, and we're going to click on next here, and I left it as a default. I want to integrate it within the Active Directory. So from here, I just clicked on next. Now the path automatically goes to the C drive. Because my MDT deployment share is on the D drive, I like to keep the remote install in the same path or the same location of where my deployment share. So the C drive, I changed it to the D drive, clicked on next. For my Pixie server and issue settings, I normally like to do response to all computers, known or unknown, and I click on next, and it's gonna start doing this thing. I like to uncheck add images to the server now because I normally don't do that right away, and click on finish. Okay, that's half the battle. So let's go back inside our MDT. We're gonna right click on the main node, and the main node for me is MDT deployment share. Right click on it, update the deployment share. You get the nice little wizard. I left everything as the default. Click on next. Next, it's gonna start doing this thing. It's gonna start creating the 64-bit and the 86-bit boot images. And once it's done, it's done. Now we're gonna go back inside WDS. We need to add that boot image so we can boot inside our MDT environment and start, you know, deploy our task sequence. So within the right-hand side, we're gonna right-click on boot images and add a boot image. We're gonna click on browse. Now the location is where you drop your deployment share. Mine's was the D drive deployment share and is inside the boot folder. Within the boot folder, you're gonna see two WIM files, 64-bit, 86-bit. Now I'm gonna be deploying within a 64-bit environment. So this is the one that I chose and I clicked on open and that's it. Click next. I left everything as the default, but you are able to change it depending on your environment. Click on next, next again, and basically you're done, okay? I have a habit of always doing this within my WDS, but you don't really need to do it. I like to right click on the primary node of my WDS, go to all tasks, restart it. And once I say it's successfully restarted the WDS deployment, that basically tells me that everything is working with no problems. It's a good thing. So okay that. And within my VMware workstation, I created a VTest virtual machine just to test out the deployment. And I powered it on. Once I powered it on, it started to Pixie boot. And I hit enter to Pixie boot onto my WDS server. And that's the IP address. I hit enter. And as you can see, the server name is vmdt8456.mydomain. Hit enter. It's going to start processing. And the only image that I have being advertised within my WDS was the 64-bit one. And once it processed, it's going to start loading up. And eventually, you're going to get this. Run the deployment wizard. Now, the only reason that I'm getting this is because I didn't really customize the custom settings.ini file or the bootstrap.ini file. This is basically a straightforward installation. We are going to click on run the deployment wizard, provide your username, password, and domain, click OK. This is basically to establish the connection to continue on your deployment. And once everything works well, you should see the task sequence. Pick your task sequence. We only created one task sequence together. So select it, click on next, provide a computer name. If you want to join into the domain, go for it. For me, I left it as join a work group, click on next. I'm not going to move any data or setting. I'm not going to do a restore of users' data. For your locale and time, change it to you. Again, you are able to customize all this stuff within the custom settings.ini file. But for me, because we're doing like a fresh installation, I left it as is, and this is the reason why I'm getting this. For capture image, I left it as do not capture the image. BitLocker, I'm not enabling that right now. And hit begin, and it's gonna start processing it. And then eventually it's gonna start partitioning it, and it's gonna start installing the operating system. It's gonna constantly reboot a couple of times. You're gonna basically see these screenshots that I'm showing you guys right now. And once you see this stuff, this is a good sign. It basically means it's installing the operating system successfully. When you get the nice little hi, we're getting everything ready for you. This is a good sign that basically tells you that the operating system was installed successfully. And when I got this, I was like, okay, it's a waiting game. And eventually it loads into your desktop. It's gonna start running all the actions within the task sequence. It's gonna start applying the cleanup. It's gonna start applying the tattoo, the restore user state if I have that enabled, restore groups, and when everything is done, you're going to get success. That's a good thing, right? That means the deployment was completed successfully. And that's it, guys. That is how we install step-by-step MDT 8456. We basically install WDS, pushed out the operating system, how to import the operating system within MDT 8456, how to create a task sequence, how to upgrade the deployment. We did a lot of stuff. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. Don't forget about hitting that like button. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.